Welcome to Real Food, and today I've got one of the very original snacks or meals which actually come from East London, and it has a very long, rich history, and it's called jellied eels. Well, jellied eels are actually exactly what they are. They are pieces of eel in jelly. And the jelly itself also comes from eel. It's a form of gelatin that this oily fish produces. They are cooked already, and then they're put in these pots. It says on the cover here that it's not suitable for home freezing, but I did freeze this pot actually, and I read lots of articles and reviews. The reason why they put it's not suitable for home freezing is because gelatin in low temperatures can actually sort of it can lose its shape and texture, and this is I guess what will happen with my eel. But the fish itself, when frozen, is still okay. You know, it's going to be good to eat. So it's actually defrosting now here, I will try this jelly when it defrosts to see what it's like. I suspect I wouldn't want to eat the jelly, but the fish itself inside will be good. And apparently it's one of the most nutritious types of fish. It's got really good levels of omega-3, and it's also tasty. And what I'm going to cook to go with it, typically it's served with mashed potatoes, but I don't have potatoes. I've got sweet potatoes, so I'm going to prepare mash from my sweet potato, and I guess it will be just as nice. So it will be jellied, very traditional East London food, jellied eel with mashed potatoes, made with sweet potato. So I'm going to defrost my eel, and while the fish is defrosting, I'm going to prepare my sweet potatoes. So with my potatoes, it's going to be relatively simple. I'm going to take the skin off, first of all. And then I'm going to boil segments of my sweet potatoes, and I'm going to then mash them with a little bit of butter and maybe some herbs, a little bit of salt, and I think that should be it. I know some people might want to add egg, but I think a combination of sweet potatoes, it's already very flavorsome anyway. And if I use some herbs, I think egg will be an overkill. So that's the plan. And I find these peelers really, really useful. You can peel potatoes, apples, basically any fruit or veg with thick skin. These are very good tools. Here we are. So the skins are gone now. I'm now going to chop it into smaller segments. I find it really easy to boil my sweet potatoes if they're cut into smaller segments like this. It takes less time, and they cook very thoroughly. You can test it and with a fork, and once you've got your softness level of softness achieved, you pretty much know it's going to be like that inside as well. Whereas if you use very large chunks, sometimes it can be soft on the outside, but inside it can still have a fairly hard core. So, but I think in this case it will work. So this is it. So now this will go into hot water, and I will boil it. Okay, so my sweet potatoes are now soft and ready for mashing. I've got some butter. This butter is salty, so I might add a little more salt later, but I will first see how it works with this amount of salt. So I'll let this butter melt first of all, and then I'm just going to mash my potatoes with this fork. So I wouldn't need any additional instruments, I think, because look how easy it is to mash. You know, sweet potatoes are very, very soft if they are cooked thoroughly, and they're very easy to mash. Look, it's practically ready now. A few strokes with your fork, and your mashed potatoes are practically there. I'm thinking to make it more interesting, I'm thinking to add maybe some herbs. And I'm thinking what herbs would work really well. And you know what? It might be interesting to add some cinnamon. Yeah. Just a little, you know, I'm not gonna go too crazy, just a touch like this. And some cayenne pepper. This could be interesting. They're both brown and red, so it's going to look natural. Okay, well, that was a good serving of pepper. I hope I've not overdone it. Hopefully not. Okay, well, let's mix it together. Yeah, you kind of have to be careful with peppers, so if you don't want it to be too spicy or too hot, especially when everything is red or orange, you know, you can't actually see how much you really added. But I hope it will be okay. It's the first time I'm trying this one. Let me try it just a touch. It's actually delicious. It's really, really sweet. And that's why I can taste my peppers. I'm going to add some more salt because the potatoes are actually sweet. And with cinnamon, it becomes more like a pudding. Ooh, I've added a good dose of pepper, so I can feel it now. It's getting better now. Yep. Better and better. A bit more salt. But I'm only adding tiny amounts, so hopefully it's not going to be too salty and too peppery. So my eel is still defrosting. I'll wait for it to fully defrost. But in the meantime, my potatoes are actually nearly there. My potato tastes delicious. Perfect. Really nice. That little bit of cinnamon really does spice it up quite nicely. Gosh, these potatoes are absolutely amazing. I hope I don't eat it all before my fish defrosts. Definitely really good. So I have now defrosted my jellied eel, and as you can see, well, the jelly, you know, as expected, is a bit mushy, so it's not really the same texture. I mean, it is still, you can still see jelly bits, right? But the eel is what I'm most interested in. So what I'm going to do, you see, it's like ice that turned, it's like mushy ice, really. I think most of it I'm not going to eat, so I'm going to discard most of it. But I will try some, because I want to taste, you know, to see what it tastes like. So let me try. Okay. It's not bad, actually. It's like nice, salty, fishy. Yeah, it's fairly pleasant. But you probably wouldn't want to eat all of it, actually. But the fish itself, I think it's still quite hard. So it's not finished defrosting fully. But I just wanted to see and maybe transfer it to a plate. But I think it needs to defrost a little further. So I'm going to get rid of some of this. But you can see these are nice meaty chunks of fish. So, and this, what I wanted to do, I wanted to put it in the, into a plate, which I'm going to use Okay, so yeah, so it needs to defrost maybe a little further, but I think I've got enough jelly with these actual meaty bits, so I can actually get rid of the rest, because look, there's enough jelly and enough actual fish in there. So this can actually now be discarded. So I'm going to put this back, because I don't want to clog my... I don't know how thick this jelly is. I don't want to clog my... So this is it. So, I mean, jelly is still usable, but it's basically that kind of icy, mushy consistency. So you might not necessarily like it this way. Okay, so I've got my eel now. It's more or less defrosted, but also, just to make it a bit more interesting, I'm going to add some lemon juice. So I'm going to add some lemon juice, and I also want to add some Japanese teriyaki sauce. So it's going to be like a Japanese almost meal now. So, and this could easily go with rice. Well, I've had my sweet potatoes, and they were so good that I've actually eaten them all. I couldn't wait for my eel to defrost. But this will be just as lovely. So it's like a nice Japanese, almost Japanese, whatchamacallit, ramen, like fish ramen. So it's got a nice bit of teriyaki sauce and a bit of lemon. So it's perfect. I already tried a little bit. It actually tastes delicious. The fish is perfectly fine. So what happens after freezing in the freezer is the jelly that loses its shape. But the fish itself is fantastic. So it's meaty, it's lovely, it's retained its flavor, so it's all good. So on this lovely note, let me wish you bon appétit, and we'll chat again soon.